welcome to Between Two Fernies. I'm your host, Sean Fernie.
And I'm your co-host, Justine Fernie. And together we make up Fernie & Co. We're a West End Toronto real estate team. Got it. Thank you.
Yeah. On today's episode, we're going to be talking about pricing. It's such an important component to your overall go-to-market strategy. So maybe, Justine, you can tell us a little bit about your approach and why it's so important.
Yeah, we do a lot of research before we list any of our houses. And it's not that we're not about getting the most money for your house. That is absolutely what we are all about. We're not part of the model. We're not volume driven. We're not listing low and selling fast. We are listing what your house is worth at market value and seeing where it goes. Generally, we know a house sells always for what it's worth. People don't tend to overpay for houses unless they are unicorns, you know, unless there's some kind of emotional connection that's made that goes above and beyond reason.
Yeah, I mean, generally speaking, I think you, somewhere along that garbly gook that you were talking about, I could have. The boring button was right there. Yeah. Pricing a house too high can be a recipe for a bit of a disaster. I mean, the house will sit on the market, the listing will get stale, you have to lower the price. Agents can begin to take advantage of the fact the house has been sitting on the market. So it's really important to try and price the house appropriately for the market and what you have.
Sean, can you speak to like bidding wars and what happens when a house sells way above ask?
Yeah, it's crazy. I mean, we've used the strategy in the past, but you'll notice a lot of realtors posting sold over ask. You know, really the reason those houses have sold over ask in 90% of the cases is because the strategy there is to artificially reduce the value of the house. So price the house 5 to 10% less than ultimately what it's worth in hope of stimulating a bidding war. And you know, you hope multiple people get an emotional connection to that house and ultimately pay more than it's worth.
Do you like that strategy?
In some instances, in some neighborhoods, it works. But in most cases, what we find is that they ultimately sell for what they were worth to begin with. And it can be an added stressful situation for the seller because they're a little unsure of exactly what they're dealing with.
Also, then, you know, you may have all this early interest and then you get to offer night and you don't get any offers. Not the best strategy. It's one that works at certain price points too.
Yeah, we've been in situations where we've gone in, recommended a listing price, only to lose the listing to a competitive realtor who, you know, maybe went in and said their house was worth more than it was, only to see that house sit on the market, price reduction, and ultimately sell down the road for pretty much what we originally presented. To your point earlier, we want to get the most possible money for our clients' houses, and we've set some records in doing that.
Lots of them.
But we also don't want to artificially overprice a house because that can
be... Just to get the listing.
Yeah, just to get the listing. Imagine the stress and strain of going through that.
That was easy.
And just hire Fernie & Co. Probably, you know, that's the best idea.
That's, you know, yeah. At the end of the day. So that's a wrap on our episode of pricing. Please like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We'll be doing another video very soon, and our next video will be focused on strategy and marketing.
But we're going to blow your minds with that
episode.
Yeah,
it's pretty important stuff. But anyway, thanks for tuning in.